Welcome back, and to shed more light on the situation in Somalia, we are joined in the studio by Dr. Mohammad Higazzy, former Assistant Foreign Minister for African Affairs. Hello, Dr. Mohammad, and welcome to our show.
Hello, Jean. How are you?
Sir, now the UN Security Council has extended its AMISOM mandates by a year. How do you see such a decision will have an impact on the ground, especially in light of fighting against al-Shabaab?
Thank you very much. As you have mentioned, the UN Security Council have adopted the resolution 2275 presented by the United Kingdom and unanimously endorsed by all members, including Egypt, which is a non-permanent seat for 2 years in the Security Council. The importance of this very important resolution is that it renews the international commitments towards a problem that has been with us for almost now 26 years since the eruption of instability in Somalia, and the situation has started now to improve. The UN mission was to be completed on the 30th of this month, and tomorrow is the last day. So last week on the 24th it was the renewal of the mandate of the UNISOM, and the importance of this integrated UN intervention into the Somali political reconciliation and reconstruction institutional building in Somalia is so important and fundamental, as it coordinates also the work of all the UN agencies as well as the NGOs in a way to establish a reliable reconciliation process and a constitutional changes that will bring a credible electoral system into action, as from August 2016, in a road that will lead to a general election in 2020. Having said that, one has to also read into the resolution the call for all the parties in Somalia to work with the presidency, to work with the UN. And I'm sure that the effort by President Hassan Sheikh Mahmoud and the Somali parliament will be enhanced. We need all the federal actors also to mend fences and to assist the process. The UN have clearly declared in its resolution its commitments toward more cooperation with the local authorities to enhance its capabilities, being it political or military or humanitarian aid. Before I end in answering this first part of your question, let me mention that Somalia has truly suffered a lot. As I said, 25 years is a long time for a nation to endure difficulties, being it politically, humanitarian, and terrorism as well. So Somalia truly is a wound in the heart of Africa and the Arab world. And the time has come truly to the international community to work hard towards enhancing the Somali capability, being it political, as the process is going on, or humanitarian, as you may also noticed over the past years, 2 million Somali refugees around the region and the world, 4.5 million Somali suffering malnutrition and under very severe conditions, among them 300,000 children is under threat. So there is a call to the international community to further enhance its support. Out of $1 billion US dollar needed, we are talking about 36 million offered to Somalia. How can a country endure such difficulties besides the plague of terrorism and the threat that al-Shabaab or al-Qaeda related organization is posing to the country? Gladly, the al-Shabaab organization has been defeated in many places in Somalia, thanks to the African Union deployed forces, as well as the Somali National Army and National Police, which requires support as to enable Somalia to carry on its responsibility in defending its interest.
So do you believe that the African Union forced the AMISOM, as you mentioned now, are exerting effort and supporting the government in its fight against the Al-Shabaab movement in Somalia? Are they really lending a great hand at this?
Absolutely, they are playing an important role, but look, Dina, we are talking about two bodies. One is regional and one is international. The AMISOM, the African Union deployed forces, is very important as an instrument, helped and helping the Somali national army and national police is fundamental, I guess, to enhance the combat or the fight against terrorism or Al-Shabaab movement in particular. But the UNISOM, the referred to resolution was to renew the mandate for one more year to the UNISOM, because they are the guardian of the political process and national reconciliation and relations with the Somali parties. As you know, we are talking under the auspices of the UN and the auspices of the Somali parliament and government, of an electoral system that will lead Somalia in August this year to an election that will end up by selecting 275 members of the lower chamber or the parliament, and then an upper chamber of 75 members. The first plan is to select the new parliament with the division of what they call it 4.5, which is four big clan equally selected, and the coalition of smaller clan in 5%. So we can move ahead with the process that will lead to a general election in 2020. And I think the resolution has given a momentum and has given a platform to Somalia, which we all hope to see back on its feet, which we hope to see a national army capable, in help, of course, of the regional players and the international community as well.
Okay, sir, the mission is facing problem in funds, especially after the European Union, which is one of the main financiers to the mission, reduced the budget by 20%. So how do you feel that the mission will continue this way, and it's facing problem in finance?
I agree with you. It is a complicated issue. There is no way that Somalia, by its national armed forces or the police, can face the challenges. They need definitely the AMISOM contribution. It is important. They have truly proven to be very useful to stabilize the country, to defeat Al-Shabaab in many locations. Now they are only concentrating in the south in Baidoa, but in general, they have lost a lot of centers, and they are faced by a strong African contingent, but the problem, as you said, lack